I'm Emmy Bretschneider, and I'm a urogynecologist here at Northwestern Medicine. At Northwestern Medicine, we do offer minimally invasive surgical approaches for patients with pelvic organ prolapse. Minimally invasive surgery has a lot of benefits over traditional open modalities of surgery, primarily because it decreases patient complications, improves pain postoperatively, and can improve overall quality scores, quality of life scores for our patients. As minimally invasive surgery becomes more widely adopted throughout the U.S. for surgical management of pelvic organ prolapse and enhanced recovery after surgery pathways, that's ERAS pathways, become more commonly adopted, we're able to discharge our patients earlier following surgery than we once had in the past. So for our practice here at Northwestern Medicine, we actually do discharge our patients on the day of surgery following, as long as they're meeting all of their postoperative goals. And because of that movement towards same-day discharge, we really wanted to explore what factors are associated, say, with adverse outcomes following same-day discharge, and if there's a difference between patients discharged on the same day versus on the day following surgery. And we studied this, and we used actually the NISQIP database to investigate this question. We found that there was actually no difference in outcomes. So because there has been this shift towards discharging patients on the same day following their surgery, rather than, you know, the more traditional post-op day one, post-op day two discharge, we have made it a really central focus of our practice to really underscore patient education. So really sharing with patients the data behind why same-day discharge is important, but also trying to communicate to providers within Northwestern Medicine that this is our practice pattern and it is safe. Big data is a large part of my research interests, and my colleagues and I wanted to look at outcomes in older women. You know, aging is a known risk factor for pelvic organ prolapse, and a large proportion of our women are, say, 65 years and older. And so the Medicare database is really useful in addressing questions or conditions that affect older patients. And so we use the Medicare database to explore outcomes following minimally invasive surgery for pelvic organ prolapse, not only outcomes, but also readmissions. The reoperation rate for women undergoing minimally invasive surgery in this particular patient population was about 4.5%. And the lowest risk of reoperation was actually seen in the cohort of women who underwent an obliterative vaginal surgery, otherwise known as copulocalysis. In this particular patient population, in women over 65, the most common reason for reoperation was for a sling. And that may be due to a number of different factors. Sometimes prolapse surgery itself unmasks stress incontinence, which we do treat with a sling. And so that's not surprising that patients would need a reoperation for that. Another factor associated with reoperation following minimally invasive prolapse surgery was the use of mesh to augment prolapse repair. So whether that's sacrocolpopexy or vaginal mesh. The reoperations that we did see for those patients tended to be mesh excisions, and luckily none of those are really associated with any great comorbidity, but it is an important factor that we do address when we are offering mesh augmented approaches for prolapse repair. There are studies that show that approximately 20% of women do undergo surgery for a pelvic floor disorder in their lifetime, and so a lot of patients do have these conditions and don't necessarily share the fact that they're suffering from these conditions with their providers. That being said, pelvic organ prolapse is common. However, our treatments for pelvic organ prolapse are largely focused on patient symptoms. So if a patient isn't particularly bothered by their pelvic organ prolapse, then we don't necessarily need to offer them invasive treatment modalities. But of course, chatting with patients about their options regarding prolapse can be really beneficial and be really empowering for women. Our team at Northwestern Medicine is truly excellent. We are dedicated to patient satisfaction and patient outcomes. We have a multidisciplinary team that includes pelvic floor physical therapists, urologists, GI specialists, colorectal surgeons who work together to optimize patients who have pelvic floor disorders.